Yeah!
What's up, everyone? My name's Kyler. I'm the newest addition to the Monday Mods group. And what I have to offer is a street sleeper. It's cash. 6'9", Chevrolet C10. Basically, my goal is with this to be the ultimate farm truck sleeper. And why I say farm truck is obviously Street Outlaws farm truck. This is a red cousin. So basically, I acquired this truck. It is my girlfriend's family truck. It actually sat in the field for over 20 years until I came along and said, you know what? This truck's got potential. Let's kick Jeff and Anthony's ass. That's the key goal there. So I ripped her out of the field with my Jeep and said, the original intent of this truck was just to get it going, just to get it driving. And then it turned into, okay, well, the motor is in it. I'm going to make some power. Well, then it went, well, screw that motor that's in there. Why don't I make it some power and put a 350 in it? And then screw it, why not just make it a street slash strip truck? So kind of morphed into, it's going to be hopefully a budget fast truck. Got it out, got it loaded up, brought it to the shop here to work on, and started tearing it apart. So this truck used to belong to my girlfriend's great-grandfather, and he passed away, so this also will be a memorial truck for him. Obviously, it was a farm truck, and we're going to keep the old look of the rustic truck, and then put his farm decal on the side, just like that, make it a memorial truck. So we'll just go over the truck a little bit. Like I said, it's a 69 Chevrolet C10. Motor that's in it, I've already kind of tore apart. It is a 307, so nothing too crazy, but it was locked up, so we weren't able to crank it over in the field. I put a battery in it, it just barely turned, and it just quit. So as much as I would like to leave this motor in here and how good of condition it is, as you can tell, it's been freshly resealed. Had a brand new distributor in it, brand new points, everything like that. As much as I'd like to keep this engine, but we will still keep this engine around, and I will bring it back and rebuild it. But the goal is to put a 1998 350, so a Vortec 350 in it. That way it's a roller motor, I can make some more power with it. That'll be swapped in, and we'll take this motor out, still get it freshened up and get it freed up to keep it around and get it running for future project. Maybe go back in this truck at some point, but right now, going with the 350, and kind of fits because the transmission, it's got a turbo 350 in it. We thought it was a power glide at first, just from the stories we were told. Turns out it is not a power glide as much as I wish it was a power glide. Turbo 350 will be just fine for this old rig. Obviously, factory AC, real nice, real nice. As you can tell, we already started stripping it. We got the hood over there. There's the head I pulled off. I mean, this motor probably wasn't going to run if it did crank over. We got stuck valves. I mean, obviously, didn't have any tension off it because no push rods. That valve is not seating correctly. You can tell rust was there. There was water in number 8 cylinder. That one's not seating correctly. A lot of carbon buildup. So, safe to say, this motor wasn't going to run if I did get it to turn over. Like I said, not a huge deal. I'll work on it once we get the motor out. This had a bunch of, you can tell, baling twine just laying in there. Surprisingly, no holes in the bed, so that's good, except the part that Jeff and Anthony are going to be looking at the most. She got some speed holes in the tailgate just for aerodynamics. That's all that's there for. You know, she just opened real. We're going to act like that opened. She does have one speed hole in the bed. Like I said, aerodynamics. Well, we're looking to replace all the taillights, obviously, and everything like that. And wheel and tire setup right now, I'm don't have the foggiest idea of what I'm going to do with those. I mean, these are just tires to get out of the field because this thing would barely move with the tires I had on it. So we just threw these on there. They were on the Silverado laying off to the side. So I said, screw it, put them on there. Then it come over here. Got another factory vent. Like I said, she's rusty, but she got a little speed hole right there. Just throw tacks out, pop everyone's tires down the drag strip. Hey, just can't beat that. Just listen how solid that is. That's just solid. That's money right there.
I hear pieces of it falling off.
And guess what? It gets faster every time I do it. So yeah, basically this is going to be the new truck on the channel. I said budget. So I'm broke, don't have money, but you know what? I still want to do some half cool truck. And just, like I said, at the end of the day, this still is a memorial truck. Get back on the road again after sitting 20 some years in a field. I think it's going to be real cool, even if it doesn't meet Jeff and Anthony, which it will. It'll be all right, because at the end of the day, it's still going to be a cool truck to go drive down the road, enjoy with my girlfriend, just have a good time with it. That's all what I'm really looking for. So if you guys have any suggestions, or if you're knowledgeable about these trucks, because I'm not too knowledgeable about them. I mean, I've done some research and everything. If you guys know any like good aftermarket radiators, like what should I do, like electric fan, like fan clutch, stuff like that, where I could go get good parts and everything like that, or different suggestions, I'm all ears. Take any help I can get.
Oh, this hurts.
I'm actually surprised I'm doing this. My groin is shaking right now. All right, guys, like I said, my name is Kyler. This is Kaylee. We're the owners of Cash the 6-9-6-10. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, hit the bell icon, do whatever, or don't. It don't matter to us. Just kidding, it does. Please subscribe. To catch up with more updates, Cash the 6-9-6-10. Thanks for watching.
Roll out.
Weight reduction.